Hello, I'm Jason Stevenson, and welcome to tonight's sleep story that follows Kira as she journeys to Clearview River, where she camps for 3 nights. Along her journey, she uncovers deep truths and insights about the world, granted to her by the wild nature she finds herself immersed in. As you open up to Kira's journey, see if you can let go of your own story for the time being. And with each breath out, imagine all thoughts and worries and all beliefs departing your mind and body. Kira sat on the quiet bus as it wove its way through the green countryside. The 2-lane road was surrounded by lush forests and scattered fields, shimmering beneath the mid-afternoon sun. In Kira's part of the world, the season bordered spring and summer. The air was warm but not too hot, and the sun hung high in the sky for much of the day. Kira was on her way to a favorite stretch of woods, one in which time does not matter and simply being is of top priority. She made her way across the land for 3 nights of self-guided retreat in the wilderness. She knew the woods she headed to better than she knew herself, having come here hundreds of times in her life before. It had been some time since her last visit, but the forest was etched deeply into her cellular memory. In fact, Kira grew up just next to these woods. As a child, she spent many mindful hours humming through the trees. She built forts and wrote poetry, listening into the quiet whispers of all those who lived in the forest. She kept a small diary in which she would make note of her conversations with the forest creatures, the butterfly's secrets, the caterpillar's mission, and the fox's many tricks. But that was many years ago now, decades in fact. Kira hadn't spoke to the woods like that since her family moved away from this part of the country. When she was 12, the family moved from the glorious countryside to the buzzing metropolis of the big city. It dazzled the entire family. Shimmering lights, colorful culture, and an endless list of places to see and things to do. Many years eventually passed, as they do, and Kira stayed close to the heart of the city. It delighted a piece of her, and yet the other half longed for the quiet solitude of the woods. Once a year or so, Kira would make a commitment to come back to those woods, and during this particular year, she was committed to a 3-night stay. The bus continued to weave through the land. Soon, the fields were long behind them and dense evergreen forests stretched into the distance. The terrain began to climb and descend, rise and fall, as the earth below became rich and rocky. Kira gazed out the window. Deep relief filled her bones. Last summer was the last time she'd been this far north. Her soul had been patiently waiting. The stop nearest to where she was headed was just up ahead. Kira pressed the button just above the window to signal to the driver that she would be getting off the next stop. The bus pulled over, and Kira retrieved her backpack from the storage area beneath the bus. Her bag was heavy, full of the food, water, shelter, and warmth that she would require over the coming days. If she needed anything else, she knew she could take a day hike into town to pick up the necessities. Slinging her pack onto her back, she pulled the straps tightly, and as the bus pulled away from the stop, she turned to face the hiking trail that led deep into the woods. Kira knew exactly where she was going. Her favorite camping area was a patch of land just next to Clearview River. As a child, her family would take short trips there, sometimes staying overnight, sometimes just for lunch. The sound of the river was like a symphony of a thousand instruments. She longed to hear it again. And so, step by step, she meandered through the woods. As spring was now making way for summer, the forest's plant life was in full bloom. Ferns, flowers, shrubs, and fungi were taking their place upon the floor of the woods. Overhead, the leaves of the deciduous trees glistened in the glowing sunlight. Maples and birch trees blended seamlessly with the coniferous trees, the pines, cedars, and spruce trees. As she walked, Kira remembered to breathe deep. The air was much different here, much different than the air she absorbed in the city. It didn't take long before the sound of rippling water entered Kira's ears. Somewhere off in the near distance was Clearview. It sounded just as soothing, just as alive, as it had in years before. Joy began to permeate Kira's bones as she continued along the small trail in the direction of the flowing water. She wandered over fallen logs, hopped over small streams, and ducked beneath fallen branches. And soon, between the trees, the glittering, flowing water came into view. Kira made her way towards it, soon standing right at its edge. She rooted herself into the earth, let her shoulders fall away from her ears, and bathed in the mellow music. Having stepped out of the woods and onto the riverbank, the sun was able to reach her cheeks. It warmed her body from crown to toes, sending a loving ripple throughout her body. Kira was so pleased to have arrived, but she knew she had to continue. Her favorite place to set up camp was a short distance away from the spot where she stood. And so, she found her way back to the path and followed it alongside the river, heading downstream. The flow was never too far from her. She could still see it through the airy branches. As she made her way alongside the water, the sun began to creep towards the horizon. It wasn't quite there yet. She would have more than enough light to arrive and to set up camp. But in the meantime, she reveled at the way the light shifted. Now, it shone into the forest from a new angle. In fact, it shifted ever so slightly with each breath. Nothing, Kira reminded herself, is stagnant. At last, Kira reached a curve in the trail. Her campsite was just a dozen meters or so away from the path, situated on a round plot of land just next to the river. She cut through the trees, carving out her own path. When she arrived, she let her bag fall gently off her back and took a deep sigh. She made it. This particular plot of land was Kira's favorite for a reason. Because of its unique location and the direction it faced, it offered clear views of the sunrise to the left and of the sunset to the right. She was mindful that the sun would soon be setting, and so she took her time to set up her tent. This tent was nearly 15 years old, and so she was able to set it up quickly and with great ease. She then rolled out a sleeping bag, organized her belongings, and changed into comfortable evening clothes. Kira boiled water to prepare her pasta dinner. It was ready in no time, and as she ate, she sat before the setting sun. She watched it cast its remarkable light across the cosmos. As the earth spun away from the sun, the sky filled with orange light as bright as tangerines. Streaks of whimsical clouds filled the sky. They too were infused with this amber light. Kira was overjoyed to be here. She had been longing for this retreat, and the setting sun helped her to settle into it. After the long journey to get here, Kira decided to end the day early. As the sun shifted from orange to deep purple and then to black, she brushed her teeth and then headed off to bed. She sunk deep into a sleeping bag, connecting with the solid, stable earth beneath her. The next morning, Kira woke early. Her senses stirred naturally just as the sun began to seep through the thin fabric of a tent. Her phone was off, so she had no idea what time it could be. She trusted that her body would guide her to wake when it was ready to, and to rest when it needed to. And so, she slowly stirred from her sleeping bag as she prepared for her first morning by the river. Wiping the sand away from the corner of her eyes and then pulling on a warm sweater, she crawled towards the tent door and slowly let in the morning light. As she stepped outside and turned her head towards the east, she was struck by the golden glow of light that poured across the earth. The sun was only just above the horizon, gently waking all those its light fell upon. Kira had seen the sunrise before, but something about this morning was different. For the first time, she came to deeply understand just how powerful the sun is. Without it, life as we know would not exist. We humans would not exist. This deep recognition reminded her of something that she had heard before, which is that the first thing humans ever worshipped was the sun. Centuries ago, before the discovery of electricity and even before fire, there was the sun. The sun brought warmth, energy, and illumination to the otherwise darkened world. And so now, on this cool spring morning, this worship made sense, not to a mind, but to a body, to some deeply intuitive space inside of her. And as she made her tea that morning, she sat in contemplation of this miraculous star. She offered it her deepest gratitude as she let it illuminate her mind and awaken her body. As the sun became too bright to gaze into, Kira shifted her attention to thoughts about how she might spend a day. She had brought little with her. Aside from the necessities, she carried a book, a journal, a bathing suit, and some colored pencils. And so Kira decided to spend the next few hours taking things easy. She practiced yoga on the smooth rock overlooking the river and then devoured the first half of her new book. It was a mythical tale, a novel that brought to life the stories of Greek goddesses. she let herself disappear into that enchanted world, and then took a nap next to the flowing water as the sun cooled off behind thick, fluffy clouds. When Kira awoke, she decided to stretch her legs and she took a long walk alongside the river, soon coming to a quiet area of the riverbank. Here, the water moved slowly, and through the crystal clear waters, it was possible to see the riverbed beneath. A perfect place to swim, but Kira was growing hungry, so she decided to turn back. She vowed to return the next day. That night, Kira enjoyed a simple dinner, following it up with some hot cocoa she had brought as a special treat. As the sun disappeared and the sky grew dark, Kira sipped her hot chocolate while gazing up at the glorious, growing moon. The moon was in its waxing phase. In a few days, it would be completely full of light. As Kira gazed up at it, she honored the moon as the sun's perfect counterpart, a symbol of the night's beauty and the enchantment of darkness. She felt very much connected to the moon as she stared up at it. The way it cycled through various phases of being, and yet still, at its core, always remained the same. She trusted it, opening her heart to the moon completely. She rested there for some time, sipping away until there was no more warm, hot chocolate left in a cup. Yawns and tired eyes eventually told Kira that it was time to sleep. She felt full to the brim with the day's beauty, deeply connected to the natural cycle of the world. She welcomed the coming night just as she had welcomed the morning. And so she crawled into a tent and slowly surrendered to sleep once again. Her muscles melted into the earth beneath her. In the morning, Kira rose early. The sun hadn't yet shown its face, but Kira was wide awake and ready for the day. Quietly, she got dressed and tiptoed out of a tent. Only a tiny sliver of golden light lined the horizon. The sun was still 30 minutes or so from rising. Kira's mind drifted to that part of the river she had discovered yesterday, the calm, clear waters and the sandy bed below. Something called her to go there, and so she grabbed a flashlight and made her way back down the trail in its direction. It didn't take long before she reached that welcoming riverbank. The water was even calmer than it was yesterday, appearing to have slumbered throughout the night as well. The river was cool, but Kira longed to feel it against her skin. Slowly, she prepared herself to enter the clear water, inching away in it carefully. The river's depth was about waist height, and as she reached this level, she slowly dipped her head to feel herself wrapped in the water completely. She came back up for a breath and took a deep sigh, feeling revitalized and alive. And as she turned to face the east, beams of dark gold light were cast across the sky. Kira watched it for a moment from the water and then crawled back onto the riverbank to dry off. She wrapped herself in warm clothing and continued to watch the marvelous sun inch higher and higher. She welcomed this beautiful day with all of her heart. Back at her campsite, Kira had a light breakfast. Then, as she did the day before, she contemplated how she might spend the day. She looked again at what she'd brought with her, and the journal spoke. It whispered to her just as the forest had whispered to her all those years ago. It wanted to converse with her. It wanted her to fill its pages with secrets of the forest. At first, Kira was resistant, but she remembered how deeply connected she felt as a child. She felt attuned to the world completely, at one with all of creation. And so, she listened to that inner whisper. She grabbed her journal and pen, along with snacks and water, and she prepared the day for discovery. That day, as Kira roamed the woods, she kept her mind and heart open to the whispers of the forest. And sure enough, as she quietened down, the natural world around her began to speak. Birds whispered lullabies as they flew through the canopy overhead. Leaves told stories about the wind and weather as they rustled together. The soil spoke of its integral relationship to the trees and to the invisible world of microorganisms. Berry bushes spoke of the joy in creating sweet abundance each summer season. There was much to be heard. Kira took notes, wrote poems, and sketched out some of the flowers she encountered along the way. She spent many hours out in the woods, until soon, she realized the sun was setting once again. The sun had disappeared while she was caught up in its flow. Kira returned back to her tent and prepared a meal for herself. And that night, as she gazed out at the world, she reflected on the stars overhead. She heard that she, too, was made of stardust, that we all are, and quickly she realized that we're all made of the same thing. Call it stardust, call it matter, call it universal energy, or call it some other name. We're all made of some barely describable something, she realized, a something that makes this life what it is. While constellation tracing and probing the interconnectedness of life, Kira began to grow tired. She honored this feeling in her body and decided to turn in for the night. Saying goodbye to the moon and the stars, she crawled into a tent. She let her body surrender completely once again, and slowly, she drifted into a sweet night of dreams. Kira woke up to a third and final morning with a soft glow of the rising sun. In body, mind, and spirit, she felt deeply relaxed. Quietly, she crawled towards the front of a tent and zipped open the door. And to Kira's amazement, nature had come to greet her in a big way. Just beyond her tent, bending down to savor the refreshing water of the river, two deer had come to replenish. Kira watched them with awe and wonder. They were entirely enchanting, and as they drank, she raised her gaze to the sky, noticing birds dancing through the morning air. Fish jumped through the surface of the water and squirrels scurried near to the shoreline. Tenderly, she stepped outside of her tent to immerse herself in the morning's beauty. The deer turned to look at her, and she bowed her head towards them. They continued to drink, and then slowly made their way back to the trail. Life was dancing all around her, and Kira was a part of it. It seemed as though she'd never felt this connected to nature, to the universe. But then again, she realized she had. As a young girl, she was deeply connected. She was a nature whisperer, a way of being which offered her great joy, peace, and ease. However, it didn't matter if this was the first time or the 100th. In this moment, she was a part of it all, and she knew it. Kira knew that eventually she would have to head back home, but for now she sat up by the river. She watched the sun as it tiptoed its way through the sky, and the wildlife that wove seamlessly with the world. And as she spent a few final precious moments by the river, she came to realize the double meaning of its name. For not only had it granted her a clear view of the landscape, it had gifted her with a clear perspective of life and nature itself. Good night, my friend. Good night.